In this learning module, we will consider the ways in which tree maps may be used to visualize data, including their suitability for evaluating data which has been organized into a hierarchy. As we will see, a series of nested rectangles represents this data organization, and the size and color of each rectangle can be configured to represent values from the underlying data table. The first thing you should know about tree maps is that you must have hierarchically organized data in order to make this visualization type useful. The rectangles in the tree map represent the hierarchically organized groupings of data. In this example, 4 city locations are the highest level of the hierarchy, individual store numbers are organized within each location, and departments within each store are represented by colored rectangles. The color and size of rectangles are then set to represent the magnitude of a continuous variable or variables for the purpose of relative comparisons. In order to appreciate the interactive features of tree maps, let's open a configured analysis example in Spotfire. Use Open File and navigate to the file with Interpreting Tree Maps in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. This data table represents values collected from the sales of products at an office supplies company. Note that sales are organized into different regions and assigned to one of 76 different sales associates. For each order, there is information about the price and profit for the products in those orders, as well as a discount amount, which is left to the discretion of each sales associate. We have over 1,000 products, which are organized into 3 primary product categories, 17 secondary product categories, and 60 tertiary product categories. And those columns have been organized into a custom hierarchy, named Product Hierarchy. It is that information from the underlying data table which is useful for interpreting the tree map visualizations which have been created on the pages which follow. On this page, a tree map has been configured which relates the average sale price as a color gradient and the sum of profit values as a size gradient. There are currently only 3 rectangles, and both the total profit and average sales are highest in the technology product category. Interestingly though, the furniture product category represents the second highest average sales price, according to its pink color. However, the total profit derived from those sales is the lowest of the 3 categories, based upon the small size of the rectangle. As indicated, the true value of the tree map is its ability to represent hierarchically organized data. Therefore, let's slide the hierarchy slider to the right in order to evaluate the second product category level. Notice that the 3 primary product categories are still represented by the same sized rectangles, which allowed us to compare total profit values at that level. However, the color by variable, representing the average sale price, has shifted to the lowest level of the current hierarchy displayed. In addition, the size of these nested rectangles reflects the total profit for products grouped at the secondary category level. You can see that while products assigned to the copiers and fax category represent our highest average sale price, the products assigned to telephones and communication represent our highest total profit values. Moving the hierarchy slider to the tertiary product category level creates a new lowest level color assignment for comparison of sales price averages, and nests differentially sized rectangles within rectangles within rectangles in order to allow a comparison of total profit values at different levels of the hierarchy. Sliding to the final level of the hierarchy, where individual products define each rectangle, the tree map becomes increasingly crowded with nested rectangles. While this may be a valuable high-level overview of our entire product line, you may also wish to zoom in on areas of interest within the tree map. Each of the parent rectangle labels is an active link, which, when clicked upon, will zoom in to that level of the hierarchy. Once you are zoomed in to the area of interest, labels on rectangles identifying the current lowest level of the hierarchy become easier to read. We are also presented with a header across the top, which indicates our zoom path down to this subset of the hierarchy. We can click on any of these parent levels in order to zoom out to that level, or we can click on the All link in order to zoom out completely. So a hierarchy slider, if presented, and the ability to zoom in and zoom out are the navigational tools which will allow you to interpret the information related in a tree map visualization. Let's proceed to the next tab, where another tree map has been configured to represent different information. The first thing you may notice about this tree map is that different categorical variables have been assigned to the hierarchy property. If we pop up the legend and widen the dialog in order to read each of the hierarchy selector labels, you can see the different columns of data which were added and the order in which they were chosen to represent this hierarchy. However, because these were added as individual columns and not a custom hierarchy, there is no slider available to adjust the level of the hierarchy displayed. Labels for the lowest level of the hierarchy, order ID, were turned off due to the number and size of those rectangles. Note that rectangles change size based upon the sum of sales, and the color by variable represents an average of the discount amount applied to the order. The color by property has been configured using a segmented color mode, and a number of points were added in order to define color thresholds for each segment between the minimum and maximum at values of 2, 5, and 10%. With that understanding of the tree map configuration provided in this high-level overview of our sales activities, if we want to examine the details for any of the areas in the tree map where a preponderance of red rectangles suggests that the sales associate in that region may have been over-applying discounts, hovering our mouse over a rectangle will present select values in the tooltip information box.